Drop it.
Hello guys, I am Sunil and welcome to my channel New Developer and welcome to this series of library management system. In the previous video we have created this manage book page and I have already uploaded 6 videos. You can go and check out the videos. I recommend you to follow this video from scratch, and after completing all the video you will be able to build an awesome project. So in the previous video we have created this. If we go back, we have our awesome admin dashboard. Let me click on back. Okay, why back is not working? It should work because we have. Okay, let me just check why it is not working. So go to design and here change the event mouse click, and here we have to enter the code. I think I have copied the button, so the code got removed. New home page and home dot set visible true and dispose. Okay, let me run it again. Now you can see when we click on back, we are here to our admin panel, and when we click on manage book, we will be redirected to our manage book page. And now the next thing we want to do is we want to add details to this tables. Suppose if user entered here 3 and enter book detail here, and when he will click on add, the record should be added in this table. Okay, so in this video we are going to do this. And before starting, if you have not subscribed to my channel, go subscribe the channel. Here you will find awesome videos on Java projects or PHP projects, and in the playlist section you will find many playlists. You can see here Java library management system, e-learning website and Java fees management system, and I will be uploading more videos. So do subscribe the channel and let's start the video now. So just we have to create a method to insert the details, update the detail and delete the detail. So go to source, and where we have created this set book details to table, in below this method we have to create another method which is public boolean add book. Okay, now just provide a command to add book to book details table. Okay, it's always good to provide a comment. And now we have to just fetch the value from this text fields. So I've already created, or we have already created these variables previously in the previous video, which is string book name, author, book ID and quantity. So let me just add values to this variable. So book ID is equal to txt book ID dot get text. And here you can see we are getting an error. Why? Because this book ID is of type in type, and when we and get text method returns string, so we have to convert it into int. So integer dot spelling mistake integer dot percent. Okay, integer dot percent. Now the next one is book name. Okay, book name. Okay, I am thinking I have to just change this method names because I want to follow this camel case notation. Book name and book ID. Okay, now here we have to also change book ID and book name, because in Java we usually declare variables in this format, camel case notation. First letter should be small and the first letter of second word should be capital. And txt book name dot get text, and the next one is author is equal to txt author name dot get text. and the last one is quantity is equal to txt quantity dot get text, and I have to convert it into integer dot parse int. Okay, spelling mistake. Integer dot parse, again spelling mistake. Why integer dot parse int, and just close the parenthesis. And we got our four data here, and now I want to write the query to insert into database. So try catch, and I want connection object using this db connection class which we have created earlier, db connection dot get connection, or you can simply write this code which is this one, class dot for name driver and connection url connection con is equal driver manager dot get connection. I have already created this db connection class. If you are following my video from scratch, you know we have created this in I think second or third video, where I have created a method get connection and it will provide me the connection object, and we have created this method inside this jframe folder. If you have not created, you can simply take a look and create this method class which is db connection, create a method connection and inside this jframe. And now we got connection and statement. I want prepare statement. Prepare statement, you can see java.sql prepare statement pst is equal to con.prepare statement. Here I want to provide the query. I want to provide the query here first. String SQL is equal to, the query will be insert into book details, and here I have to specify the column name, which is first one is book name, and simply just provide the values. You don't need to specify the column name. Values and 1, 2, 4 placeholder we have to provide, not 4, let me just check, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 4. And now we have to provide we have to enter this SQL query here, and we have to provide this value to this all four placeholder. PST dot set, first one is set int because book ID. So one, and book ID, pass here book ID, book ID. Next one is PST dot set string book name. So second is book name. Okay, and now third one is set string author. So third column is author. And the last one is pst.setInt. Fourth one is quantity. And finally, we have to execute. So we are going to use execute update method because it is a non-select query, and it will return a row count, updated row count. So catch it and provide a if statement. If row count is greater than 0, that means row inserted successfully. And what we have to do is, I want to create a boolean variable here. So boolean is added, and initially I want to make it as false, and here if the record is inserted successfully, I want to change the value of is added to true. And else is added is equal to false, and here I just want to print the exception, print stack trace, and just finally return this is added variable here. Okay, we have completed our add book method. Now what I want to do is, we have to call this method on this button. So right click event action and action perform, apply an event action perform, and here we have to enter, we have to call that method. So we have to check first if method name is add book is equal to true means book added. So we have to just enter dot show message dialog dot not dot here enter here this and here we have to book added and else j option pane dot show message dialog this comma book addition failed or you can write any message no problem. Now just let me just execute this. So we already have two books. I want to add the third book. So here I want to third book I want to add. So just click here 3 and I want to name the book as PHP. PHP and author name I want to take ABC. Initially I don't know the author name and quantity I want is 5 and click on add button. You can see book added, but we are not getting our book details here. Let me check in the database whether the book is added or not. So here you can see, let me just refresh this. You can see we got our book here, but we also want to display it on our table. So what we have to do is we have to, after inserting this table book added, we have to call the method called set book detail, which we have created earlier, set book details to table. In the previous video we have created this method, you can see here set book details to table. We just simply have, we have also called this in the constructor, and secondly we have to also, we also have to call this method inside this if block. If the book added successfully, then add the, then call this method again. And what it method will do, this method will fetch the data from the database and display on the table. Now let me run it. There is still one problem. Let me show you. Here you can see we got 3 books and I want to add a 4th book. So ID 4th and name I want to insert is as any, suppose Spring. Spring is a framework of Java and I want to name any MNB and quantity I want to take as 5. When we click on this add button, add book added, but you can see we got all the data again. You can see Java, Java again, Python, Python again, PHP, PHP again. So what is happening here is whenever we are calling this method will fetch the data from the database again and it will display on the database. And also we already have the 3 data here in the table and it will not remove the previous data, it will just add the data fetched from the database. So what we have to do is we have to create a method. First we have to clear the table. Before getting setting the data to this table, we have to clear the table and then we have to fetch the data from the database and display on this table. So we have to create a method called clear table. So after this add book method, let me just provide a comment, clear table, clear table. Now method to clear table public void clear table, and here we have to create a default table model. Model is equal to typecast it default table model, and our table name is TBL book details dot get model, from where I am getting this TBL book details. You can see our book table name is, go to change variable name, you can see book, our table name is TBL book details. And the next is we have to just simply call the model dot set row count as 0. What it will do, it will remove all the row and make the row count as 0. And we have to call this method after adding the book details. So after book details, just call the method called clear table. Now just let me show you how, why I'm getting this error. I don't know, just save it, error is gone. Now run it. You can see, let me insert a record file and in searching I want to enter Hibernate, which is a ORM tool. Author, let me insert any author name, and quantity I want as 4, and let me click on add. So book added, and here you can see we got only one record, so our problem got solved. Now the next is I want to write the method to update the column. So below this add book we have to create a method call to update book details. Now public boolean update books, or simply book, because we want to update only one book at a time. And here we have to just fetch these values again, so copy all these values, Control C and Control V, and just change the is updated. And here we have to write the database code, and I want to copy this. No, let me just write it. Connection con is equal to db connection dot get connection. And here I have to create a string query to update the record. So query should will be update table name, which is update book details. Set book name is equal to question mark comma book, author is equal to question mark, and quantity is equal to question mark, and where book ID is equal to question mark. This is our update query. Let me create a prepare statement. Prepare statement PST is equal to con dot prepare statement. Here just provide this SQL query, and we have to set the values to placeholders. So set string, first is author name. So first author name, so author, second PST dot set string. Not first one is book name, you can see book name. So let me just change here book name, and second one is author name. So 2 and author, and the third one PST dot set string, not string, it is int type. You can see quantity is int type. Let me go up here. You can see quantity is of type int. So PST dot set int, and third, not 32, third index, column name is, value is quantity, this one is value and this one is column index, and PST dot set int, the last one is book ID. Here I have written book, I don't know why I'm making so much spelling mistake. And here I want to insert book ID. Okay, and lastly we have to execute this query. So PST dot execute update, because it is a non-select query. If it is select query, we have to use execute query method. So int row count, and if row count is greater than 0, then is updated is equal to true, else is updated is equal to false. Now just print the exception, print struct trace, and lastly return this is updated variable. Because our return type is boolean, we have to update some boolean value. If the record is updated successfully, we are returning true, and if record updation failed, we are returning false. Now we have to call this method on this. First let me just copy this method which we have created, which we have added on back of the button. So copy this, control C, and update, click on update, event, action perform. And here I just want to paste this method again, and instead of add book I want update book. Update book is equal to true, then book updated, and clear table and set record, and here book updation failed. Now let me just check whether it's working fine or not. So I want to update the last record, which is 5th one. I want to update the quantity. So the initial quantity is 4. I want to make it as 5. So clear enter 5 and update. You can see book updated, and here you can see it became 5. And I want to change the author name of this third record, which is PHP. So click here, and I want take any name, JBD, and click on update. You can see the record updated successfully. Now the last one is delete. It's also very simple. We have to create another method, come down where below this update book, create another method, provide comment method to delete book detail. So public boolean delete book. Now let me just copy. Here we required only one field, which is this book ID. By using this book ID we are going to delete the record. So here I want to take a boolean is deleted, initially make it false. And now inside try catch, create the connection object db connection dot get connection, and prepare statement. Now first let me create a SQL query. String SQL is equal to delete from book details where book ID is equal to ? And just create prepare statement PST is equal to con dot prepare statement. Okay, and enter SQL variable here. We have to now set the value to this book ID, and this book ID is int type, so set int 1 comma column name value is book ID, and just simply execute this. So execute update method, you can see execute update, and here we have to get the row count, updated row count. And if row count is greater than 0, then is deleted is equal to true, and else is deleted is equal to false. And here print the exception, and finally return this is deleted variable, and all done. We have created all three methods. Now we have to call this method on action perform event of this button. So right click on this delete button, event, action, action perform, and here we have to enter. So just copy this code, if else, so copy and paste it here. And here we just have to change the variable method name, which is delete book, book deleted, and book here, book deletion failed. Now let me run it. We have successfully completed the manage book module. You can see when I want to delete this last record, so select this record and click on delete. You can see book deleted, and you can see the record is deleted from this table. Okay, so now we have successfully completed our manage book module. Now the next module we want to create is this manage student module. Everything will be same, just we have to create a manage book. Similarly, we have to create a student table, student details, where we are going to store the student, and we are going to perform similar operations. So okay, that's all in this video. Do subscribe the channel. If you are facing any problem, let me know in the comment section, or you can just follow me on Instagram and ask your doubt here, or you can mail me at inukdeveloper0@gmail.com. you will find my mail ID inside in the about section of the channel, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.